Hi, my name is Christopher Orth, and thank you for spending some time with me on this video series. I've worked at several large game development companies, and I've shipped titles for consoles, handhelds, and desktop game systems. And because of my experiences with these several different game engines, Playmaker was really familiar to me right away because it draws from the best of the best, and then it goes on to make a lot of things even better. But I realize that for many people, a tool like Playmaker can be pretty unfamiliar. So I wanted to help those people get up to speed as fast as possible so you can all go out and make some great games. Also, there are many people who are comfortable using Playmaker, but may not have had the opportunity to learn some of the bread and butter techniques that so many games use. I start out with an introduction to states. If you've never used states or state machines before, these first two videos are just what you need. Then I move on to show how to start triggering states and changes from various sources, and how to develop somewhat more complex functional state machines. Then I take FSMs to the next level by introducing variables, global variables, and how to send events between FSMs. These are really the backbone of leveraging Playmaker to its fullest. And finally, I use the last several videos to explore these concepts in increasingly complex applications of Playmaker FSMs. Knowing these basic bread and butter techniques will enable you to creatively apply them to a wide range of functionality in virtually any game. The examples I show are in 3D, but these techniques and approaches do apply just as directly to 2D games, so don't worry that you're going to be left out. You get to see some of the design and development process. In most of these videos, I generate the examples while you watch. While this series is a healthy exploration of Playmaker, it is not a step-by-step walkthrough of every feature. I assume you already have Playmaker installed, and I assume you have at least a basic understanding of how to get around in Unity. This is also not an introduction to 3D and making games. I assume you understand concepts like parenting objects, transforms, materials, stuff like that. You don't need to be an expert at these by any means to get a lot of value from these tutorials, but having a working knowledge of the basics will be very helpful. Finally, this is not an introduction to programming. I will show you some techniques that are really easy to accomplish in Playmaker that would otherwise require you to know how to script or program. And if you do have those skills, it will be a big advantage when you use Playmaker in your own work. But at no point in this series will I be showing you how to write any code. So maybe you're an artist who just wants to see your assets working right away in a game engine. Maybe you're a designer who wants to rapidly prototype so you can share your ideas with other people. You might be a small studio looking to leverage modern tools to get more done faster. Or maybe you're a programmer who will be supporting and developing for team members who are using Playmaker. This is for you. So let's get to it.